Good morning, people. Watch MS65, Lisa Boyce. I'm going to give you the gospel, and I'm going to give you a little message about pre-trib rapture and the Antichrist. It's a short thing, but excuse me, something's been brought to my attention. The gospel is in 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4. Christ shed his blood for all of our sins, past, present, and future, was buried and rose again on the third day according to scripture. We're saved by grace through faith in Christ alone, not of ourselves, not of works, lest any man should boast. It is grace, something we didn't earn, something we don't deserve, that God gave his only begotten Son, and whosoever, you and I are whosoever, the key word is believe in him will not perish but have eternal life. How do you come to that? You admit you're a sinner in need of Christ. The moment you put your faith and trust in Christ Jesus, the moment you accept Christ as Savior, not only are you saved, but you are justified by the blood of Jesus, rapture ready, which is going to happen at any time, and sealed until the day of redemption, which means you cannot and will not lose your salvation. The Holy Spirit will indwell in you. The Holy Spirit will lead you, guide you, minister to you, encourage you, give you discernment, change you. He's your best friend. So it's brought to my attention that there's videos going around saying that we have to see the Antichrist before the rapture. That's not true. Not at all. Does that mean that the Antichrist is alive? Yes, he is alive, and he's actually in office. The fact that the Antichrist is not revealed until after the rapture is in 2 Thessalonians 2, speaking of the day of the Lord, and Paul writes that the tribulation will not begin until after the Antichrist is revealed. The rapture happens before all of this. That day will not come until the rebellion occurs and man of lawlessness is revealed. Now, does that mean that we as Christians will see the Antichrist? No. Not in his power. In the book of Revelation. The restrainer is the Holy Spirit. Okay? If you read 1 Thessalonians 1 Thessalonians 1 talks about the actual rapture in detail. 1 Thessalonians 4:14 through 18. We who remain and who are alive, I'm paraphrasing, will be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. Then we go to 2 Thessalonians. I think what it is is that so much is happening right now that people honestly think that we're going to still be here when the Antichrist arrives. And that is not true. Like I said, he is alive and he is in office. But he will not take over world domination. In other words, he don't know who he is until the enemy puts it in him. And the church won't be here. And if you think about it, it makes sense that somebody has to be on the scene because everybody else is here on this earth now. All the world, so-called world leaders are not doing a good job to him. So he's going to take over, especially after millions of people disappear off the face of the earth. I think that'll be the final straw right there. So, whoever's going around making videos about the Antichrist being on this, having to show before the rapture, is wrong. Is wrong. You can believe what you want to believe, but that's the truth. And that's that. I can't point it out no other way. So, like I said, you can believe how you want. It's up to you. But that is the truth. That's God's word. And if you want to paraphrase, I mean, you can go to Revelation 3:10, which is one of my favorite verses. And that'll tell you right there that, no, we will not be here. So I got this morning, and this Let me see. Did this come out this? It actually came out a couple of days ago. So, Chinese warship is going to circle Japan ahead of a G7 summit. Now, the G7, let me get this. Hold on a minute. The G7 is supposed to happen. Let me get the date for that. The G7 is happening soon. I know that. It's going to be in Hiroshima. So, this warship and the People's Liberation Army Navy Surface Action Group is continuing its circumnavigation of Japan ahead of the annual G7 summit later this month in Hiroshima. The Surface Action Group, which includes cruisers, destroyers, and fleet and other fleets, were sighted at midnight this past Thursday, sailing southwest in the area 56 miles of the east Sumasu Island that lies between South Japan's capital of Tokyo. Now, it then says the SAG then sailed west between Sumasu Island, according to the Joint Chief of Staff of Japan's Ministry of Defense. So what's happening now is that China is escalating with China now. The movement of the planned ships come ahead of the G7 summit, which is scheduled for May 19th through the 21st in Hiroshima, Japan. Chinese media said the movement was a message to Japan following various remarks by Japan's leaders about Taiwan. Hold on. Now, it says last year in May, Chinese and Russian bombers conducted a joint flight in the same day. Sleepy was meeting his Australian, Indian, and Japan quad group counterparts in Tokyo. So far, beyond the releases, Tokyo has not issued any statements about the planned ship movements. Japan Defense Minister made no comments on the ship in his regular press conferences on Tuesday and Friday, though the transcripts also showed that reporters did not ask about the ships. Meanwhile, Russian Navy corvettes, RSF and 333 and RSF 335, along with another fleet, were sighted 10 a.m. Friday. Now, this was not, I just now found out about this. Sailing southwest in the Sea of Japan at an area 50 miles northwest. The three ships subsequently sailed southwest through the Tsushima Strait and entered the East China Sea. Fast attack craft also entered. I told you all weeks ago, yesterday, China and Russia are together on this whole thing. Now, this is what I'm getting. When China attacks Taiwan, Russia's going to be with them. It's not Russia you have to look out for. It's China. is China. The only thing that Russia has that we don't have is weapons, nuclear weapons. They have more. With that being said, with the two of them together, they can do a lot of things and a lot of damage. It's not so much Russia, it's China. So I'm going to link this in the description box. I'm getting also this. I had just said last night that all these nations are together. Russia opens his bank in Iran. Russia's second largest bank, VTB, has opened a branch in Iran, the country's trade promotion organization announced on Twitter Tuesday. The VTB is the first ever Russian bank to offer services in the Islamic Republic. The majority state-owned bank will promote trade transparency and play an effective role in transferring part of the foreign exchange earnings to the banking network. Last December, VTB launched a service allowing both individuals and businesses to transfer money to and from Iran. It's one of the first Russian banks to be excluded from the SWIFT global payment system over Moscow's military operation in Ukraine. This thing is moving so fast. So fast. Yeah, the rapture is next in line on God's prophetic calendar. I'm going to link both of these in the description box. And I will be back later. So I'm going to link this and the other article about China in the description box. Like I said, it's not so much Russia that we're looking at. It's China. And now you got all of these Chinese people coming over here. Why? So I'm going to link this in the description box and I will be back later because there is more news coming out as we speak. Thank you.